Welcome to Anita's Guide to Simple and Easy Cooking. I'm Anita and today I will show you how to make okra curry, which is also known as lady's finger or bindi. So let's get started. To make our bindi curry, I've got here 500 grams of thinly sliced bindi or okra, which is also known as lady's finger. I've got some oil to cook it in, one medium onion finely chopped, half a teaspoon of cumin seed and mustard seed, one small chili, 2 tablespoons of grated garlic, salt to taste, and 2 sprigs of curry leaf. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a non-stick frying pan and I'm going to put my pan on medium heat so I can heat up the oil. Oil is hot now. I'm going to add my seeds. Give it a quick mix before it starts sizzling everywhere. I don't want it to splatter. So I'm just going to add my onions now. Give it a quick mix. I'm gonna add my garlic and my curry leaves. And I'm gonna cook my onions till it's light brown color. Don't wanna burn it or anything, just a light golden color would be fine. So we'll just cook this for about 2 to 3 minutes and then we'll come and see how it's going. My onions are starting to get light brown color. You can have a look. I don't want to burn my onions. So what I'm going to do is add my okra, bindi or lady's finger. I'm going to mix it well. I forgot to add my chili when I was cooking my onions, so I'm going to add it now. Remember, this is totally optional. Today I'm not going to use any turmeric or anything. I'm just going to use it plain salt. And then I'm just going to put about half a teaspoon of salt now, because later we can taste again. I'm going to give it a good mix. I'm going to put my lid on and let it cook away for about 10 minutes. My bindi has been cooking for 10 minutes. I'm going to give it a mix and I'm going to taste my salt. And if you notice, the bindi is very slimy. Bindis are always slimy, bindi or okra. So I've got a secret ingredient here that I always use towards the end. I'm going to add it now. It's lemon juice. It will stop the sliminess. And then I'll give it a mix and also I'm going to taste my salt to make sure that I've got the right amount of salt. So you can just add according to your taste. So I'll just give it a quick mix and I'm going to taste. I just need a little bit more salt, not much though. And I'm going to cook this now for another 5 minutes. So I'll see you back in 5 minutes. After adding the lemon juice, my bindi was cooking for 5 minutes now. So I'm going to give it a quick mix. And I'm going to taste my salt for the final time. If you have a look, all the slime is just about gone. It doesn't need any salt. It tastes great. It's ready now, so I'm going to turn my heat off. But if you want to make your bindi a little bit more crispier, you can cook it for further 3 to 5 minutes. But it's ready to eat now, so I'm going to be serving my bindi with rotis. And if you want to know how to make rotis, I'll put a link below. Enjoy.
Thank you for watching my channel.